Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Gotham Lounge. My name is Joe, and today we're back with some more Guardians of the Galaxy. I intend to. All right, we've got our work cut out for us. But let's see.
If you're looking for units, check your own room. So, you here to talk, or you just want a gear upgrade?
Let's do a gear upgrade.
Can you upgrade me? Pretty please.
I feel like we got a lot of stuff. Yeah, quite a lot of components. All right, Rocket, let's see what we got. All right, we got a charge shot. All right, consumable magnet. Attract enemy drops from 15 meters away. Low life fire. Firing rate double when health drops below 25%. We have some things that are unaffordable. I'm just 10 components shy of getting extra health. Increased shield regeneration by... Okay, you know what? This is a good passive trait. I'm going to go ahead and get this. I just have to keep an eye out for tons more components. Thank you.
Anything else?
You're not still upset, are you?
It'd be a lot better if we didn't have 3 cycles to pay a fine.
Hey, remember that time on Conlar with the Badoon and that really hot Ascavarian girl?
Yeah, her buddies would have spaced your stupid Humi butt if me and Groot hadn't busted in.
I had things under control, mostly.
Too bad you're broke, Quill. I should be charging you for all the times we saved you.
Name one other time you saved me.
Contraxia, Nowhere, Parameter, Ceres, Contraxia again, Malador...
Okay,
yeah, that's a pretty extensive list.
I should have turned you in for Yondu's bounty. Sure as Scud wouldn't be scrounging for units to pay off your Nova girlfriend.
Ex-girlfriend. But admit it, you like being a Guardian of the Galaxy.
Still on the fence about the brand name, but keeping the Milano as collateral was a pretty smart move.
Never agreed to that.
If you'd rather, I turn you in.
Don't worry. I know you put a lot into this team. I'll make it up to you.
You better.
Open this door. I know you are in there, sentient tree. Do not think
what are you doing to Groot?
You up to.
Drac,
Peter Quill,
what's going on here?
Order tree to open this door. I am certain that the rodent has hidden a stash of units within the latrine.
I'll check on him.
I'll check on him and tell you if he's doing anything weird.
Acceptable.
Groot, you okay in there? Think you could open the door for a minute?
What?
Is that my toothbrush? Great. Now I need a new toothbrush.
What is he doing in there? I don't know. Alright, let's...
You're supposed to knock.
What are you doing?
What are you doing? You're supposed to be looking for money.
I did.
And?
I don't have any.
Also, what's with the dolls?
Do you value your life?
Is that a trick question? Okay, yes. Mostly, I value my life.
Good. Then pretend like you saw nothing and get out.
See you in the lounge?
Out.
Got it.
Well... Just leaves this room.
Any units I uncover will go directly to you, but I am unsure the others will do the same.
So, you're taking the whole find the units thing pretty seriously.
It is a serious matter.
Yeah, I totally get it. We're all afraid of going back to prison.
I am not afraid of going back to prison.
Oh, good. Because I'm not either, mostly.
In the kiln, I was surrounded by criminals, murderers, and thieves. They taught me a harsh lesson. Assassins and bounty hunters cannot be trusted.
Okay. Wow. Don't you think maybe you're calling the kettle black?
I have not mentioned kitchenware.
It's an Earth thing. What I mean is you're a convicted mass murderer. I used to be a pirate. We're not exactly upstanding citizens.
You and I honor our word. I cannot say the same for the others.
You could be wrong, Drax. You won't know until you give them a chance.
We will see.
All right. Can you let me out, please? Excuse me. Thank you. I have no idea what you're doing in there, Groot. We've got quite a problem on our hands, though. Well, this leads nowhere. That's not gonna...
So, got any ideas to get those units together?
I don't know. Trying to think of something.
Investments.
Let me see what's down here.
Investment type of guy?
You are a risk taker.
Exactly. I don't sit behind no desk all day hoping for real estate fluctuations. I go out and I do stuff.
Perhaps we are somewhat alike.
What do we have over here?
Whoa. Glad Corell didn't find that on top of the space llama.
Yeah, good thing. Okay, so nothing there. What about through here?
Oh, Drax! Did you bring out your staff to hidden unit?
I do not hide my unit in staff. I am not a rodent. Neither am I.
You are rodent like. You're annoying like. That is not a valid taxonomic order.
Great. We are not getting anywhere.
Why you gotta be so paranoid, big guy? You didn't mind trusting me on Hanshi.
Trust you repaid by attempting to rob our employer.
I told you, I was just testing their security measures.
So you claim.
It's nothing for me to really activate.
Let me guess.
Team costumes.
I am.
What do you think I'm gonna do? Conjure some units from thin air?
Can you do that?
Why does this thing look so sinister?
Hey! I don't go into your room and touch your stuff, Quill.
What?
Sorry.
You hacked my visor and added a scoreboard to it.
That's true, actually.
That was different. I improved. Also, did anyone tell you that you snore? I thought Drax was bad, but wow. Quill, you should really get that checked. You sound like a tor.
I don't snore that loud.
Yeah, okay.
So what is this thing anyway? Kind of looks like a metal face hugger.
That metal is face hugger. A spinal control unit.
Yes, right, of course, a spinal control thingy.
Back on Half-World, pre-scientists use these to keep us super soldiers in line. They'd press a big, fun red button and zap! Instant obedience.
Holy crap. Rocket. What exactly did the Kree do to you?
They ripped me apart and rebuilt me over and over and over again until I became this half-finished thing they could mold and shape and control.
Oh. Rocket, I had no idea. I mean, I knew the Kree Empire was desperate, but...
Do you know what it's like to lose all control of your body? To be in constant pain, trapped inside yourself, unable to stop the horrible things you're doing? That control unit made sure I did what I was supposed to do. Oh yeah, whether I wanted to or not. A neat, furry little machine of death. Didn't take long to figure out I was better off not fighting.
Okay. Then let's shoot this thing out the airlock. Have a little middle finger salute ceremony to the bastards who built it.
I don't think I'm ready to let go of that part of me yet. Maybe one day.
Are you 100% sure you want to keep it? What if it...
controls me? I decided a long time ago, Quill, that I would never let anyone control me again. As far as I'm concerned, this is just another useful piece of junk and a few bad memories.
Rider and the Resistance. Like I was finally in control of who I wanted to be.
Yes, exactly. Those first few years, it was like I had joined this really big, really dysfunctional family, which, now that I'm hearing it, would make Yondu my...
Space Dad?
Could have been worse. Well, if you don't mind, I think I'd like to be alone for a bit.
Oh, yeah, sure. I'll see you around.
All right.
Well, well, well. Let's see if we can find some stray units in here. Really?
So, not much.
37 units?
Okay, that's not even close.
They appear to be 7,963 units.
We intend to keep our ship, Peter Quill.
I know. We clearly need a plan.
And reconsider my initial proposal.
Oh, no, not Fin Fang Foom again.
Yes, we should go after Fin Fang Foom.
Drax, there are easier ways to get paid. Like, what about selling Gamora's crap?
What?
Oh, come on. You've been hoarding them stupid knickknacks ever since you first joined us. I mean, don't tell me they ain't worth nothing.
Quarantine zone was always
holding out.
My figurines are not knickknacks.
Team's in trouble. Then you can't be bothered to make no sacrifice.
I will sacrifice your head.
Guys!
Hold on.
Let's just...
Fing Fang Foom, I want to know more about it.
Fing Fang Foom is the fiercest, most legendary monster in the galaxy. Shatters the bones of all that go after it. The skulls of the greatest hunters are impaled upon its fangs. Well, imagine the glory of such a death.
Our goal isn't death, Drax.
Glorious death!
Out of the question.
Well, in that case...
You're not selling my stuff!
I am Groot. I am...
He says we should combine both ideas.
Sell Gamora's trinkets to Fin Fang Foom. It is brilliant.
Yeah, you know, the only problem with your plan is that Lady Hellbender only buys monsters, and you are not a monster. He's not. He's the sweetest, most...
I am Groot.
No, you don't. This ain't something you can pretend.
I am...
Oh, boy.
You want monster? I'll show you monster!
Whoa, guys!
Groot, are you really offering to...
No, he is not offering that, okay?
It could work.
Sell Groot? I guess we could bust him out after.
Absurd. Lady Hellbender seeks the monster within. A small, ugly one is clearly the correct choice. He's cruel, sadistic, and his soul is filthy and filled with rage. Monster Queen would pay a great sum for such a creature.
Really? How great?
How are you okay with this?
Because I know what I am, and I know what he ain't.
I am Groot.
Other than the fact that
I
he's
vote
Groot.
Groot. I honestly think Lady Hellbender will go for it.
Yeah, well, I vote for not Groot.
I also vote for the creepy little beast.
2 votes each. Peter?
Oh, boy. I have to choose who to sell? Rocket? Ugh. I guess I'll sell Groot.
Well, I think Groot's more convincing, in the traditional monster sense. Groot, buddy, first of all, thank you. And second of all, I want you to know we're gonna bust you out of there right after, okay?
I am Groot.
All right, let's do this. Let's go sell a monster.
So I guess we're selling Groot.
We're not seriously flying into that.
Stephnock 9, Stephnock System Greater Magellanic Cloud.
That's not how women work.
Or weather. Anyways, I'm sure it looks worse than it is.
Fortress.
Get us in close. house, Quill. I don't want to walk in this.
Whoa.
Yep.
You're flying the wrong way.
Nah, he's not flying at all.
Guys, relax. Just one. Liner. Adjustment.
Piece of cake.
You can't be serious.
What? This way we can scope things out before we finish the transaction.
We're like 100 clicks from her base.
You know how much I like scoping.
Her pack's still far away from it.
Next All right. time, I'm flying.
Are you sure the Leafy One is ready for this?
Nope.
He'll be fine.
Don't you get all gloomy right now. Don't help.
Because you're constant complaining, Gus?
You are complaining about the short one complaining.
We're all complaining. Happy?
Okay, here we go.
Off we go. To the unknown fortress.
Hellbender's castle isn't even that far.
That is not a castle. It is an impregnable fortress.
So how do we impregnate it?
Ask Peter!
Let's just get closer. We'll figure it out on the way.
There is nothing to figure out. As beast merchants, we will easily gain access to Lady Hellbender.
Good! We've already got a beast. All that's left is the merchant part.
Good thing I put on my official merchant costume.
There is
Good
no
thing.
Such thing.
Ouch.
Ouch! Hey, is my jacket all right?
At least you got it.
I don't think you ripped
Some
anything.
Of us are soaking here.
Less whining, more walking.
Hey, Stormlord. We ain't seriously walking through this. It'll take forever in this storm.
Stop complaining. The hardship will
Build morale. Everybody's yelling at each other.
It'll be fun. Woohoo! Team hiking trip.
That's just a fancy word for walking.
Come on, at least you won't be bored.
Okay, guys, if we just keep our footing, it'll be a straight shot across.
We got this. Just don't fall and we'll be fine.
Agreed.
As long as we don't fall.
Almost sounds like you want to get hit by lightning.
I would not expect a Chitauri trader to understand the underlying
value. The underlying
All right, let's grab this.
Of being direct, you child of subterfuge.
What is your problem?
Lady Hellbender scoffs upon duplicity and
Guys.
Can we refocus here? We're here to trick some lady, not kill each other.
She's not just some lady. Lady Hellbender is a known warrior.
And a queen.
And stinking rich.
Exactly. She's a stinking rich warrior queen business.
Whoa.
That was way too close.
Well played, Lady Hellbender.
So we're still doing this? Yes!
Yes, we're still going. We've already made it this far.
Guys, focus.
This wind is wicked. I do live for danger. I didn't make that jump. Okay. Oh my god. That pushed me so far backwards. Okay, I think that was supposed to happen.
Everyone okay? We should have gone to Mako 4.
Literally, everybody's just yelling at each other the whole time.
Things been shot to hell.
No doubt by this one and her Chitauri friends.
We weren't friends.
Guys.
Okay.
Not sure.
Not the first time we've seen one of these.
It ain't moving now.
I would be wary of it.
You know what? I survived freaking Half-World. I think I'm scared of some little...
Whoa!
It's not alone. Get ready!
All right, here we go. Keep hitting the wrong thing. Finally.
Destroy! Perish!
time.
I slice off peas and it grows back.
The prickly interior must be shattered.
Oh, this is taking longer than it should.
Perhaps these were sent by Lady Hellbender. This is a test for AT. The trick is to defeat them.
Okay. We'll get there. Okay, I think I'm getting the hang of it now. I'm just trying to focus on... That's gonna be our ace in the hole. Figure I find the ace in the hole, I'm getting brutalized. If I even upgraded the right thing. Finally figured stump one other thing out.
Sure that you have crushed it. Tearing flesh from its bones appears to do nothing.
Enough with the jelly! Break its bones!
Oops! God. Finally.
So that's what a monster around here looks like?
We are outside Lady Hellbender's sanctuary. The creatures here are not her pets.
All right, we gotta get moving.
Having fun?
Didn't think I'd ever be shooting at a resistance ship. Drax, you could pull this reactor out gently, right?
If it were combustible, the rodent would have shot it by now.
He makes an excellent point.
Will I continue ripping it apart?
No. I think we're good.
Great. We made it halfway up.
I'm going to scout ahead. Try not to kill yourselves on the way up.
There they are. Wing controls.
Wait, what is this?
Your magical mask revealed.
Give me a second.
What's taking so long?
Peter Quill is dilly-dallying in the rain.
Not dilly-dallying.
I'm thinking.
Connected to nearby devices.
The mud in this area smells queer.
It's them jelly things we fought. I think they, secrete in here.
You mean that we are standing in a latrine?
Not all of us!
Drax, you ever seen one of those?
I suggest smashing this electronic device until...
No! Keep your grubby paws off of it! I'll take care of it!
Alright, Rocket's gonna do it. Cool.
Sound like no jelly thing.
They say that Lady Hellbender's call echoes throughout the planet.
That don't sound like no lady either.
No idea what this is. Collateral damage. Alright, we'll hold on to that. Everybody else is down this way.
Careful! Looks like something big moved through here.
Yay!
If you see anything with claws the size of Drax, let me know.
I thought we already had our monster. What's she tracking this thing for?
For sport.
Nothing wrong with a little sport. A girl has to keep busy.
You are looking for trouble, assassin.
And you came from over here. Oh, perfect. Take those.
I am eager to experience Lady Hellbender's legendary battle.
Yeah, I bet you are.
What's the weirdest monster you guys have seen?
I once saw a brood-transformed Regalian wearing a Clintar parasite.
You could fit a lot of teeth into a head that big.
You have no idea.
Ooh, mysterious!
Found something, Quill!
Yeah, some kind of cave. Maybe it's got hidden treasure.
Peter Quill, I have found the way forward.
And hello, mystery goo.
Got several things here. Some components.
No, just trying to stay ready.
Hold on, what's over here?
Monster eggs. Yay. Okay, so note to self. If it looks like a monster cave and smells like a monster cave, and you're on a monster planet...
Whose idea was it to make these sharp on the inside?
Just some jelly, dudes. I took care of it.
Come on, Scott. I knew I should have come down earlier.
Wait, so where are you?
Cave X. Where are you?
Trying to find my way back.
Passage.
I ain't far, Quill. Scream really loud if you find another blob creature.
No, I will.
Hey, listen, while it's just the two of us.
What's up?
You're busy exploring. Just meet me in the main cave when you're done looking around.
All right.
New Gamora outfit. Nice.
You done exploring, Quill? Because, I really need to talk to you.
Okay.
It's something, personal I need to get off my chest.
What's going on?
Look. I'm not sure about this whole selling Groot thing.
Rocky, we've been over this. It's gonna be fine.
Yeah, but what if it's not? What if something bad happens? Groot's the only real family I got, Will. He's the only one who's accepted me for me.
Groot offered to do this.
And if Gamora offers to tell a joke, you're just gonna assume it's funny?
Not sure I get where...
I'm saying Groot ain't built for scheming. He ain't no monster.
We don't know that.
It's obvious.
Maybe to you. But 3 out of 5 of us think he's monster enough. So give him a chance. He knows what he's doing.
Fine. Have it your way.
Come on. The sooner we get the Lady Hellbender, the sooner we can focus on paying that stupid fine.
Easy for you to say. You ain't the one getting auctioned out.
All right, we fell down through here. Nobody decided to come in with me.
Don't worry too much.
Still no sign of whatever made those claw marks?
No, just some jelly dudes.
Then it must be out on the hunt.
All right. Let's pick up where we left off.
This jungle is majestic.
Whoa!
This is further proof that we are not welcome here.
If we turn back every time we have wanted, we never go in.
Good point.
This place is a flark of maze. All those trees look like
giant strings of saltwater taffy.
What? What's taffy?
It's sweet and delicious and it melts in your mouth.
And looks like a tree, apparently.
And it is made of salted water.
No, that's just the name. Drax, think this is a sign from Lady Hellbender?
We are clearly not wanted on this planet.
Good thing we have a plant guy to take care of a plant problem.
He says plants aren't problems.
Okay.
I don't know. Rocket, can you take care of those branches?
You want me to blow it up?
That shouldn't be our answer to everything.
It's the answer now.
Here, Gamora.
Whatever it takes to find Hellbender.
Her name is Lady.
The last one I pick.
Yeah, Gamora.
Let's go, Gamora.
Have to start showing some respect.
This from the guy who calls me Harlot Spawn of Thanos.
An accurate description. We all know which Harlot.
Focus.
Guys, monster planet, dark, dangerous. Can we focus here?
Are you frightened of monsters, Peter Quill?
Only the scary ones.
We'll need to find a way out of this jungle.
Why? It's dry down here.
Should we ask them for directions?
I'm thinking maybe they are directions.
Seriously? Oh, like a signpost or something.
I'm not saying it's an arrow with the word fortress on it, but statues suggest civilization. The only settlement I saw when we were topside
was Lady Hellbender's fortress.
Dead end. That's just great.
Wait, is that Chitauri tech over there?
Ask the Chitauri.
No, it is. It's a retractable bridge. They used them at the prison I was in.
Too bad the controls are on the other side of the giant chasm.
What are you?
Whoa!
I shall hurl the creature over the chasm so he may activate the
breach. I may activate a hole through your face! Put me
No,
down.
We are not throwing him.
We're not throwing rockets.
Very well.
You sons of forking dogs!
How will we cross?
Don't face
Look
dogs.
Around, we'll find another way.
Rocket appreciates you defending him. Alrighty, guys. I think we still got a long way to go in this jungle. So we'll continue this in the next episode. So on that note, guys, I'm going to actually go ahead and end the episode right here. So thank you guys very much for tuning in today for this episode of Guardians of the Galaxy here in Gotham Lounge. If you guys enjoyed the video, please go ahead and leave a thumbs up on the video and feel free to leave a comment down below. As always, if you'd like to continue to stay in touch with us, watching future videos, or videos of our past, just go ahead and hit the subscribe button on the lower right-hand corner of the screen, and you'll get a bell notification every time I upload a brand new video. So once again, guys, thank you very much for tuning in today for this episode of Guardians of the Galaxy here in Gotham Lounge, and you guys have a fantastic day!